হ্যালো হাসিব, ভালো গফুর, হাউ আর ইউ গাইস?
হ্যালো স্যার, আই এম ফাইন, হোয়াট অ্যাবাউট ইউ?
হ্যালো আবদুল্লাহ, আবদুল্লাহ থ্যাংক ইউ ফর জয়নিং। আবদুল্লাহ, ইউ শুড বি ইন কোয়েটা। হ্যাঁ, আবদুল্লাহ ইউ শুড বি ইন কোয়েটা। আবদুল্লাহ সুমরু, নেমরা হ্যাজ জয়েন্ড। We can wait for another couple of minutes before everybody joins.
Assalamu alaikum sir.
Walaikum assalam. Saif has joined. Okay. I can share my screen and discuss today's agenda. Just wait a minute. So, Haseeb, Ghafoor, Abdullah, Nimra, Saif, Khalid. Haseeb, where is Abdullah?
Sir, he said he will join at 5:40.
Why?
Sir, because of light.
Why?
Because of some light issues and because of load shedding, the network also doesn't properly in this area, so cannot trying to port connection.
Okay. And who else is missing? Noreen nahi hai. Noreen nahi hai. Kainat nahi hai. And where is Basharul? Basharul is also not here. Okay, so Basharul, Ghafoor, can you ask Basharul where is he?
Yes, sir, I am messaging.
Yeah, text him. Should we start?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So today we have got, you know, let me record, start recording. Okay, pause recording. It means it is already recording. Okay. So today we've got two agenda. The first agenda is to cover, you know, generative deep learning. And today we'll only cover text generation. And based on this, I have uploaded an assignment that you guys need to complete. And the second is this neural machine translation along with the transformer attention model and you know, its implementation. So hopefully we'll be able to cover today generative deep learning with the support of LSTM and then move our focus to neural machine translation and then understanding the attention model and then understanding the transformer concept, and will end at implementation of transformer. So these are broad agendas for the day. Before anything else, let me show you the assignment. So when you are attending first part of the lecture, you should have this assignment in your mind. You should know that you will be using the concept that I'm going to cover today. You will be using it in this assignment. So this is assignment number 5. I've already uploaded. The deadline is Thursday. Thursday means 10th of December. So 10th of December is the deadline for this assignment. In this assignment, the objective is to practice text generation, right? Because text generation is a creative side of deep learning. I mean, when you talk about when you talk about script generation, when you talk about article writing, when you talk about chatbots, they all are, you know, examples of text generation. So we need to understand this a beautiful idea of text generation in deep learning, because deep learning is not only, you know, classification and you know, or maybe clustering. It is also about this creative side of artificial intelligence. If you remember, I told you in 60s and 70s we promised that, you know, AI will be AGI, artificial general intelligence. We said that artificial intelligence should be replacing human, and its creative ability should be as good as human. But we could not meet that promise. I mean, we did that promise in 60s and 70s when we had Prolog and things like those. In 90s, we again promised that we are almost there. Now we can have creative side of AI. Now robot should be able to write a script for the movie. A robot should be write lyrics for the new song, and robot should be able to generate news article. It should be able to even write research papers. We kind of made these promises even in 90s. But believe me, in 2019-20, we are very near to meeting those promises. Even some of the evidences that have been published recently, which are showing that the promises that we AI people did with the rest of the world are now, you know, very close to be you know, fulfilled, because we now have this ability of you know, generative ability of artificial intelligence. So in today's class, we'll see how to do text generation using LSTM, and hopefully we'll also see that with the support of a transformer, which is actually GPT-2. So the objective of this assignment is to practice text. Whatever I will be teaching in these 50 to 60 minutes, you should be able to apply those concepts on this data set. The data set is speech emotion data set, already available on LMS. The data set is highly imbalanced. It is having 6 classes. Joy having 8,240 instances, surprise with 3,000 plus, sadness with 3,000 plus, anger with 1,500, disgust with 761, and fear with 2,816. So you can see this is highly imbalanced data set. When it's imbalanced, I mean that in each label, their number of instances are varying significantly. So the highest number of instances are in the joy label, and the lowest are in disgust label. Certainly, these type of classes who are having low number of instances, they are actually overshadowed by these type of instances, which have got high number of instances, right? One way, I mean, what we have been doing in past, in order to balance data set, we used to duplicate. We used to, you know, maybe generate all these sentences which we have been discussed, maybe 7-8 times, so that number of instances in discussed are also equal to joy. But that was not serving. I mean, usually when you are doing classification, it looks for words which are, you know, exclusive to disgust. So certainly, in that case, it was not serving the purpose. Although you were increasing number of instances, but that increase in number of instances was not increasing knowledge of the classifier. It was not increasing knowledge of the classifier, because if you were, you know, just repeating same words, so obviously that was not the solution. So it was thought that we need some alternate mechanism, and that alternate mechanism is now the text generation. In text generation, we will be generating new text, which will not be duplicate to the same previous text. It will be a new text, but synthetically, it will look similar to the old text. The beautiful example is actually, I mean, I've been showing you this for past many days. These people do not.
This person does not exist.
This person does not exist.
Exist.
So, you know, now this is a new face. This is a new face. Although synthetically, it looks like you know, a human being, but this is completely new face. You know, this is completely new face. And this lady, I mean, this beautiful lady has never existed. Eh? I mean, some of might wish if it ever existed, but she does not. Eh? So, you know, although they are synthetically very same as we people, but these are totally new contents. So when you're talking about text generation, you will say that synthetically, you will be generating text similar to the past text, but it will be new text. For example, when you talk about, student feedback, if I have given one feedback that this teacher is the worst ever teacher I have seen in my life, right? Now, if we are training our model on sentences like those, it might be able to generate another text like, this teacher is very bad and I do not like this teacher. You know, this is not very same sentence as the one which is existing in the data set, but synthetically it is same. Its meaning is same. The previous one, I mean, it was, you know, kind of hating the teacher. The new which you have generated, its sentiments will be same. Although vocab will be different, but its sentiments will be same. Right. So the idea is, I mean, when we talk about generative side of deep learning, the idea is you want to generate new contents which look very similar in the synthetic side to the old text, but still it is new text, right? So your job in this assignment will be to train an LSTM based model with GitLab Twitter, because this is another word embedding. You know, GitLab embedding is one and GitLab Twitter is another one. GitLab embedding is trained on Wikipedia and Common Crawl, and GitLab Twitter is trained on tweets, right? So obviously, when you are talking about tweets, because these are the tweets, eh? So here we should be using GitLab Twitter rather than using GitLab word embedding. We should be using GitLab Twitter, because GitLab Twitter is representing the Twitter language more than the, you know, GitLab embedding which is trained on Wikipedia. Right, so for the language similarity, we should go for GitLab Twitter. So you will, you know, embed GitLab Twitter word embedding and use 90% of the data for training and 10% of the data for test. So 10% of the data for test, it means that only 61 instances for disgust, around 155 instances for anger, around 281 instances for fear, and around 824 instances for joy, right? So obviously you should not report accuracy. This is very imbalanced. So you should be reporting complete confusion matrix, precision and recall, right? Then the next step, the, you know, crux of this assignment, train the LSTM model separately for each class label and generate enough samples for each label to balance the data set. This means to generate samples for each class label to make number of instances equal to 8,240. Because 8,240 is the maximum number of instances in UI, we want that each of these labels should also have 8,240 instances. Obviously, for that reason, you will be generating, for UI, for fear, you will be generating number of instances which is equal to 8,240 minus 2,816. For fear, you will be generating number of instances which will be equal to 8,240 minus 7,061, and so on. Right. So you will balance the data set and then retain the same model, the one which you have used here, and see if accuracy increases. I mean, my whole, you know, objective of this assignment is to see if text generation improving classification accuracy. Irfan, you have question? Go ahead. Unmute your mic and you can ask question.
Yes, sir. I was saying that we are supposed to generate text sequences for classes other than UI, not for UI.
Yes, you are right. Because in UI, you don't need to generate any number of instances. These are already, you know, maximum. So zero instances for UI. For surprise, you know, 8,240 minus 3,859. For sadness, you know, 8,240 minus 3,830, and so on. Right. Okay. So in these 40 to 50 minutes, I will be giving you the idea how text is generated. Are you people excited that text generation is one big thing? Do you feel excited? Raise hands. Yes. Do you feel excited?
We are super excited.
Just raise hand. Those who feel excited. Those who
say,
excited
wow. About GPT-3.
Bashar will say he's excited about GPT, eh?
GPT-3, yeah.
Okay.
It will be
Haseeb is excited. Saif is excited. Nimra is excited. Irfan, Khalid, Manisha, Kainat. Wow. I mean, seems like you all are excited, eh? I hope you have understood the assignment. Now you can drop your hand. Okay, you can lower your hand. Okay. Thank you all. So let's see how text generation works. Believe me, you need to be with me to understand or to digest these contents, because these are a bit tricky. I mean, I'm not saying they are difficult, but what I'm saying, I need you fresh minded with me. So if you have not, you know, taken a cup of tea recently, if you are feeling sleepy, then you'll be in trouble, because some of the concepts are a bit tricky. These are not difficult, these are interesting, but they are a bit tricky. So I need your full attention on the screen. You must not be moving. You should be all the time on the screen.
Ab ja rahe hain.
Yes, who's going?
Everyone, sir.
Yeah.
Nowhere, sir. We are here, sir. We are here.
Okay. So, generative deep learning, I mean, it is used for smart reply. Huh? What is the last date of applying for OGDCL, National Intelligence Program at Sakra Agri University? Your chatbot should be generating text that the last date is August 14. That, I mean, this full sentence might not have written anywhere. The only information it might have extracted from website, and the rest of the sentence is being formulated by your smart, you know, chatbot. So chatbot usually use text generation and to answer the queries. Movie script, I mean, in real world, a lot of short movies, 10 minutes, 15 minutes movies have been written in past, and which have not only been, you know, written, but also directed and then produced. There are many. If you Google, you will see that some of the movies which are written by robots, they have been really, you know, produced. Human-like handwritten text generation. I have given you example of Guardian newspaper article, the one which was actually convincing people that AI is not dangerous for human. He was quoting Stephen Hawking, and Stephen Hawking says that robots are going to replace human. So the guy who wrote the article, the robot who wrote the article, he was actually there to convince us that no, that's not true. I'm not going to, you know, replace you. I'm going to augment you. I mean, AI is there for augmentation. It is not there for, you know, replacing us. Sequence generation, we can generate music. I know that Noreen is not here. Eh? She will be generating cuff. So cuff is nothing but sound, and she will be generating sounds. So if she can train model on 100,000 cuff sample, eventually the robot should be cuffing. Eh? Eventually the robot should be giving you the sequences which will look like human sequences and cuffing. Huh? So because sound is nothing but a sequence. So if you can generate sequence, you can also generate music, right? And music does not mean only instrumental music. Music means your cuff sound as well, right? So we can generate, you know, sound samples by using the sequence generation. Text, we'll see an example. Image, I have just shown you. This person does not exist. And video generation, you know, is still a big dream of AI. We have not yet reached there. Yes, we can generate new people, but you know, those people acting on the script, generating shots and then scenes and then a complete movie, that's a kind of aspiration. I mean, that is something that is still not materialized. We people can even contribute on that side. I mean, how?
Sir,
yes,
We can do something like video transformation, like we have neural style transfer, which generates AI style images, okay, from the real world images. So we can take frame by frame images from the video and we can apply AI neural style, and then we can again convert it back into a video.
Right. I mean, neural style transfer is one big thing. Neural style transfer, I will be covering hopefully next week. So yes, we can do neural style transfer. We have got variational, you know, auto encoder. They are very good at style transfer. They are also very good at removing noise from the images. So, you know, a lot of applications are there for the generative deep learning. Today, we'll be focusing on only text generation, but next week we'll be focusing on image as well as video, because GAN, the generative adversarial network, these are actually you know, huge, you know, news in the deep learning, because the website that I showed you, these people do not exist. That is actually based on GAN. This is actually based on GAN. So we will be covering GAN hopefully next week, because today my target is to fully focus on text, and then when I will be again, you know, shifting my focus on images, we will cover at that stage again, hopefully on oncoming Friday. But today our focus will be on generating text, and then, you know, moving to this neural machine translation, attention and transformer. Okay, so let's get our hands dirty with the real work of generating text. You know, a very simple concept. My God, I mean, why this idea did not come to me before the guy who has proposed? Because idea is very, 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 very basic. See here, in any, you know, generative model which is there for generating text, it will have some initial text. I mean, this is its kind of weakness. It requires some initial text. So it will have some initial text. Right, we call it conditioning text. The initial text are the conditioning text. You need to provide that conditioning text. Then if you have already trained a model, if you have already trained an LSTM on some huge corpus, on some huge data set, then when you give the sequence to this model, the idea is we want to predict what should be the next character. What should be the next character? Right, so in this case, if I say the cat sat on the M, we want to ask model, what do you think? What should be next character here? So it will give you probability of all the characters that this model has seen so far, all the unique characters, right? Now the unique characters, you can argue, come on, there are only 26 characters, A to Z. But these are not the only character. Right? Space is a character. Special characters are a character. Right. So when I say unique character, I do not mean only alphabet. I mean space as well as other special character. Right. So here we'll get probability, the probability of those unique character. Now the first option is whichever character has got the highest probability, we can take that character and then, you know, attach that with this one. Probably, if this model has seen cat too many times in past, it might have also seen that cat usually appears with milk, and then it also sees M, another evidence. So there, the model can give us high probability of, you know, I, right? But there is an issue. I mean, people say that you should not go for this solution. They say if you go for this solution, you will only be generating duplicates. Because what you are saying that give me next character which I can attach with M. Now model has seen in past M means milk. Why? Because it has already seen cat. So if you follow this strategy, if you end this model here, if you hide the sampling strategy, then the problem is your model will be too predictable. It will always be showing you same text, the word which has got highest probability. Now that word which has got highest probability Now the word which has got highest probability, it will always have the highest probability. It means that you will be generating at base duplicates. So they say that you need to introduce some randomization. You need to introduce some surprise element, and that surprise element will actually cause, you know, creative side of this text generation. You want that these contents should not be the contents it has seen in the past. You want to say that these contents should not always be those which has already been generated in the past. You say that I want to introduce a surprise element, and that surprise element is through sampling strategy. So what we will do, we will not stop here. We will actually send these probabilities as input to some sampling strategy, which might play with these probabilities, change them, and might come up with a new character, right? So if it comes with the new character, so might be you were expecting here milk, but then because you played with the probabilities, you change probability of I with A randomly, so it generated A. When you attached A with this, the cat sat on the M A. You now give the new sequence to the model. Previously, this was the sequence, but now the sequence with the next generated character, which is now MA. So the cat sat on MA. Now you again say generate the probability for the next character that can be attached with MA. So again, you get the probability from the language model, you sample it. You are sampling because you want some surprise element, because you want this model should have some creativity. So that is the reason why you are going to sample, you are going to randomize it. When you randomize, you come up with T. It means that the next time it should be the cat sat on the mat. So you can say that in this case, we gave a sequence, the initial conditioning text, the cat sat on the M. It generated A for me and it generated T for me. So we actually completed the sentence, right? Just two things. One, you have to train the language model. When I'm saying language model, I mean that the LSTM, which has been trained on a lot of text, maybe Wikipedia text, maybe, you know, Common Crawl, maybe some novel from, maybe some poetry from Shakespeare, maybe a novel from Amar Jaleel. Huh? So, you know, you generate this model, you train the language model, you give it some conditioning text, it will give you probability of the character. You want surprise, so you introduce that sampling strategy. This new character will be, you know, unlike the previously you have seen, I mean, cat always with milk. You say, come on, I am now fed up to see cat with milk. Give me something new. So here, it says the cat sat on the MA, and then T. So you can complete the sequence generation. Right, so this is the whole idea. Saif, you have got a question?
No, sir.
Anybody? This whole concept is clear. Irfan, go ahead. You can ask question.
Yes, sir. Actually, I want to ask what we exactly do in this sampling strategy process.
Okay, I will be covering. I mean, we are going to see what we will do in sampling strategy. In sampling strategy, the objective of sampling strategy is just to, you know, jumble these probabilities. It is just to disturb these probabilities. Because if we do not disturb them, then after M, probably we'll always see I. And we do not want that. Because if that happens, then at base, what you will be generating? The duplicates. And we do not want to generate duplicates. We want that a new test should be generated. So if you want new test to be generated, you want some creativity in your model, then you need to, you know, change these probabilities. You need to disturb these probabilities, and you can disturb these probabilities by some sampling strategy. And that sampling strategy is nothing, just a couple of, you know, formulas. Just take log value, divide it with some temperature, and take its exponent, and then randomize, you will have completely new value. We are going to discuss it. Basharul, you can ask question.
So you said that there will be different probabilities for each characters, right? So how it's generated? I mean, how it's calculated, the probabilities for characters?
You mean these probabilities, which we gave before sampling?
Yeah.
Very, very, very good question. See here, In past, if say for example in your language model, it has seen aim for 1000 time, right? Out of those 1000 time, now you've got total, say for example, 30 unique character. Though out of those 30 unique character, A to Z, these are the 26 unique character, right? A to Z are, you know, 26 unique character, and maybe space, and maybe comma, maybe tab, right? So say for example, it has seen C, right? So if it has seen these characters in past, why not? Here he, okay. You want me to?
Sir, you have to select all the characters, I think, huh? Now drag.
At least two.
Anyway. I mean, it's unlike numbers. Eh? So suppose it has
at least four to five, sir. Huh? Okay. Now you can do that. B, E.
Okay.
Now you can generate A, B, C, D from all the text, sir.
I cannot.
From all the text, select from A to E, then. Yeah, now it should generate.
No. Pathetic, you know.
No.
Your Excel is not working, sir.
Pathetic. Who's the head of Microsoft? Bill Gates. Okay, no problem. So say for example, in your language model, these were the unique characters, right? These were the unique characters along with aim. Now when it saw aim, so maybe in past it has seen aim for 1000 times. So out of those 1000 times, after aim, it saw A for 100 times, it saw B for 600 times, it saw C for maybe 200 times, 600, 800, 900, and D for 50 times, and E for 50 times. Right, so you can see the probability, this divided by 1000, right? So you can see this is how it generates the probabilities. In this case, the highest probability is for B. So after aim, in this language model, B should come, right? But now the problem is, every time when aim comes, if you give B, you cannot have new text. You will be generating duplicates. You do not want that, right? So it has actually learned from the data set what are the probabilities of all these unique characters after aim. So in our limited, you know, five possibilities after aim, the highest probability is for B. So if every time you stop here, every time you will be generating B after aim. And if that happens, you will at best be generating same text at the output what you have seen during the training time, right? I mean, next category you see B. So say for example, in the data set, it has seen B for 100 times. So after B, it sees A for 0 times, it sees B for 0 times, it sees C for maybe 90 times, it sees D for 5 times, and it sees E for 5 times. So you can see probability that after B there should be C, which means that every time model sees B, it will generate C. And we do not want that, because if we allow model to do that, then there will be no creativity, because model will be generating same duplicates. That is the reason why we need a sampling strategy here. That sampling strategy will be bringing, you know, some randomization in next character generation, which means that we can generate new contents. Bashir, are you clear?
Yes, sir. Thank you.
Nimra, go ahead. You can ask question. Nimra.
Sir, random. I mean, if there is the case, for example, after M, the probability of let's say Z is 0.00. So means it is completely random, or there is some intelligence. For example, we can select the next highest value.
No, it is random. It will do randomization. When I'm saying randomization, you will see the formula and then you will understand what it will actually do. it will, you know, increase value of some, decrease value of others, and then randomly pick one. We just want that some randomization element should be there, right? So you will see that when you apply some sampling strategy, that does not mean that you will always be selecting high probability value. That means that now the chance has been reduced that always high probability value will be selected, because the sampling strategy will be disturbing the probabilities of these characters. So when probabilities are disturbed, then, you know, at the end you might be selecting another character which may have, you know, less probability than the character with high probability. It is just a randomization technique. Eh? When you see example, you will further understand it. Clear? Okay, here is the sampling strategy. If you do not understand it here, don't worry. Eh? It is just, you know, one way of understanding it, but when we see encoding, you will further understand it. So this reweight distribution is a function which is getting original distribution. So say, for example, these are the original distributions. Eh? The later is M, the later is M, and these are the distribution that we got. Right, the later is M, and these are the distribution that we got. Right, the distribution that we got A for A, B, C, D, E. Right, these were the characters, and the value were 0.1, 0.6, 0.2, 0.05, and 0.05. Is it right? Okay, so you know, these were the possible next characters, and these were their corresponding probabilities. So we can call them original distribution, right? So we say that as per this data set, when you see M, you should generate B. Let's see how we are disturbing it. So original distribution is actually this, and then we have got a temperature value. This temperature value is actually the actual magic. Higher the temperature, higher the randomization. Lower the temperature, lower the randomization. You can see here, temperature 0.01, very low randomization. We are certain that this guy will be selected. Increased temperature, some other candidates have taken birth. Increased temperature, these guys are getting older, right? And then increased temperature, you know, now they have their wings, eh? They are now competing. Increased temperature, you can see this guy has started losing. Increased temperature, you can see the probability of this guy is probably less than this one, right? So the idea is, you increase the temperature, the randomization will be at best. If you have temperature value very low, you will have original values which were at the input. Right, now let us, Enamra, I'm coming back to you, just completing this understanding. So we will have original distribution, and then we will have some temperature value. What we are doing, we say take log of each distribution, take log of each value, take log of each value, right? So we take log of each value, right? So we take log of each value, we take log of each value. Then the next thing is divide that value with temperature. Divide that value with temperature, right? So we actually divide that value. Say for example, if the temperature value in our case is 0.5, right? We do this, right? When this happens, then take exponent of each distribution. We take exponent of each distribution, right? We take exponent of each distribution. So we take exponent of each distribution. When this happens, now the problem is, if you see some of these values, this may exceed one. It's no more probability. Eh? You need probability value. So you need that sum should be one. So the next thing that you should do is actually divide each of these things with the sum of distribution, with the sum of distribution. So say for example, I write here Okay, you can write here. You can write here equal to this divided by sum of, I doubt this will actually, okay, right. Now if I drag it, I think okay, no, I don't know about this, eh? Okay, so if this, then it should be,
sir, take sum in other column, then divide.
Yeah,
so just add dollar sign
where?
Yes sir,
just add dollar sign after the column number. $C$18, $G$18.
Absolute difference.
Here, right.
After C, sir. After C.
After C. Right.
Before G.
And after G as well.
Right.
After G.
Right. Okay. Wow. I improved my Excel, eh? Excellent. I never knew this, eh? I never knew this. Wow. Thank you very much. Now this sum should be one. This sum should be one. Right. Now see how much we have disturbed the original probabilities. This guy was 0.6, but now this is 0.54. This guy was 0.2, now this is 0.21. This guy was 0.01, this is now 0.06. This is 0.05, now this is 0.06. This is 0.1, this has also changed. Right, I mean, there is some change. If now, say for example, we divide this by 1, right, if we divide this by 1, then we can even further increase. Now this is 0.36, it has been it was 0.6, now this is 0.3. I mean, almost 50% chances of this guy has been reduced. The chances of this has increased, chances of this has increased, chances of this has increased, chances of this has increased. Right. I mean, in our case, this guy was unnecessarily dominating. So even after the temperature 1, we could not reduce its probability. But if we further increase, maybe temperature of 1.2, temperature of 1.2. Now you can see this is 0.3. Maybe further increase the temperature, make it 2. Say for example, the temperature value 2. If you have temperature value 2, now this is 0.2. Almost now he's losing. Eh? This is 0.21, this is 0.27. So you can see more we increase the temperature value, higher will be the randomization. Previously, I mean, in our case, these probabilities were too far away from each other. That is the reason why even after temperature 2, we could not kill this guy. But if probabilities are too close to each other, say for example, if probability of this one is 0.2, if probability of this one is 0.2, if probability of this one is 0.3, 0.3, 0.5, 0.7, so this is, say for example, 1.2, and this is 1.3, say for example, the sum of all these should be 1, the sum of all these 5 should be 1.
It will not be 1, sir.
Sir, aapne isko 1 se greater kar diya, 2 ko. 1.3 and 1.2.
0.2 and 0.2, and this one should be this, right? And
Or sir, make it 0.3. E.
Right. 0.07. Right. 0.07. Isko main kar lun 0.22. Right. Isko main kar lun 0.8. Right. So you can see now 0.3. 0.3 was this probability. Now it becomes 0.22, and this was 0.2, 0.2, 0.08. This 0.08 has significantly improved. This was 0.22. It has significantly decreased. So you can see more these are closer, higher are the chances that one guy will win. So 0.25, say for example, and make this one 0.27, for example, and make this one 0.18. Right. Now you can see this was winner 0.27. But after sampling, is it still winning?
Yes. Yes, sir. It's winning.
It is still winning. So maybe I just want that some guy should lose point this, and this one will be point, okay, 0.5. This one I make 0.19. Right. So 0.26 becomes 0.214. 0.25 becomes 0.212. It is still not winning. I mean, yes, Nimra.
सर देयर इज वन थिंग आई वांट टू से आपने जो लास्ट कॉलम था ना सिर्फ उसमें वो डॉलर साइन ऐड किया था मे बी जो आपके पिछले रोज है ना उसमें भी वो फार्मूला सही अप्लाई हुआ ना हो मे बी
हुआ है फार्मूला सही अप्लाई हुआ है दैट आई हैव चेक्ड दिस है ठीक है ये हो गया ये भी सही
सर लास्ट वाले में तो आपने वो कॉलम वो डॉलर ऐड किया था ना
सब में ऐड किया मैंने पहले वाले में ऐड किया एंड देन आई ड्रैग इट सो दैट फार्मूला इज ओके But you can see one thing, which is all these values, they are being updated. But here, my world is very limited, only 5 characters, right? But when you will have, 60 characters, they are probably will be very close to each other. And then temperature will very quickly, change those probabilities. So the guy which will be winning, he might be losing at some temperature value, right? So the idea is, with all this mess, what I wanted to show you that with these 2-3 steps, log, exponent, and division by the distribution, you can see that these probabilities now have been changed. Obviously, it's still some of the probabilities before randomization and after randomization is still 1, but the good thing is these probabilities have significantly changed. Irfan, question?
Sir, I think it will again the dominance will be remain up the value having higher probability with this formula.
It will not. I mean, in my case, I'm keeping significant difference among probabilities. Probably that is the reason why. Maybe.
Yeah. Yes.
2-5, right? 2-5, 2-6. This becomes some value maybe 0.05. Right, 0.05. Okay, so 0.14 I have to add. So 0.19. Right, so 0.25, 0.26. So 0.21. Maybe wait a minute. I have to 0.5. Right, okay, right. So what happens, 0.24, 0.24, 0.06, 0.19, 0.24. It has reduced, right, to some value. If I
say no, sir, I think it's correct now. If you see that earlier C has 0.26 probability, and now it says 0.254, but whereas B is now having 0.245. The next digit is higher.
C is winning.
So significant.
I do not want C to win.
At some extent. No, C should.
Now, with increased temperature value, the next one here is 1. Huh? If the temperature value is 20, 0.0217, 0.0215 at some state.
With decreasing temperature, it's making true your statement, I think.
Yeah, I mean, because if you increase temperature value at some stage, 0.0, it is still winning. But maybe because my world is very limited. If I have got more characters, then you will see that these probabilities will be disturbed. The idea, the whole idea is you get a distribution, you disturb them, you get a new distribution, and that new distribution, as you increase temperature value, in my case, because values are very arbitrary, 0.1, and there are only few possibilities. But if you've got more possibilities, then probability values will be very closer to each other. So there, you know, minimizing some values will be easy, and maximizing other will be very easy. You can see here in this case, temperature value, earlier only this guy was winning, but when we increase temperature value, you can see their probability also increases. Increase temperature value, their probability also increases, and this probability decreases, right? And then you can see if you further increase the temperature value, eventually you will see that this guy, which was very predictable, whose probability was the highest, is now losing, right? So the whole idea is to disturb these probabilities, and that we do through log and through exponent. With this in mind, now let us see the code. You get this idea?
Yes, sir.
Got this idea, guys?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yes, sir. Now let us see code. In this problem, you know what we are going to do. There are some steps which I want to clear on you before we actually see the code. Can I have a video setting, choose virtual background? Okay. Do we have, annotation? Yeah, draw. Can I have a screen where I can write here?
Yeah, sir. Click on share screen and then whiteboard, sir. Zoom whiteboard.
Okay. Share screen and
then. First, now click on share screen and then select whiteboard.
We have got one participant can share at a time, multiple. Okay. Sir, yes, then. Whiteboard. Wow. Okay. Right. So I can write. Very good. Right.
You are writing through mouse, sir?
No, I'm
not. Okay, you have touch screen.
Right. Okay. So I'm going to explain what actually this problem will be doing. What it will actually be doing, eraser for one. Okay, come on. There is the pen. Select. Okay. No,
click on draw and then select first one option. Click on draw and then select first one option.
Okay. Draw and then?
And then first one option, sir.
Okay.
Card.
Okay. Right. So here we will have a model like this. To this model, we will give a sequence, right? Sequence may be hello, hello, right? What we want, we say that in this data set, we will have maybe 60 unique characters. For example, so this is first unique character, this is second unique character, up to this is 59th unique character, right? We want to say that tell us what should be after O. So for each of these words, we will have their probabilities. For example, after it gives me, I mean, after generating initial probability and after, you know, performing temperature, this says there should be R. So we will, you know, attach this with hello WOR and then give it back to the model. The model can predict the, you know, next word. Right. Okay. Here we need a lot of data. Now, a lot of data can be Wikipedia, a lot of data can be anything. But for this example, we will be using some of the one novel from a philosopher, Note. Note is a very popular philosopher. We will be using his text. But, you know, we need to prepare data. Now, we need data so that we know that what are the sequences, what is the sequence size. Maybe if I agree with the sequence size 60, then from that novel text I will have to extract all possible, you know, sequences of size 60, give them as input, and from the data set I see that what is the next character with that sequence, Right. See here. If I stop this, stop share, and now if I start sharing a screen, look at this text. Look at this text. Right. For example, if my sequence size is 60, say for example, or maybe if my sequence size is 10, my sequence size is 10. Say for example, if my sequence size is 10, right? 10 means 10 character. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So this can be my 1x, my input, right? Now, if you give Christian in, then what should be the next character? What should be next character?
T.
T. Output is T. So we say that we want that our model should learn all the sequences of certain size from this text. And for each sequence, we tell the model what should be output for this sequence. So if the sequence size is 10, again, say for example, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. What should be the next character?
Space.
Space. So we will train the model that after impossible, you should give us a space. Similarly, if the sequence size is 10, then if we select sequence from here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, then what should be the next character?
R.
The next character is
R.
So we take this complete text, which is available on Amazon. This is nothing, just a novel from this philosopher. We actually take all the sequences from this text of size 60, right? And we stay by three character. We stay by three character, which means that we'll select a 60 character. Say for example, these are 60 character. Then the next sequence will not be from here because it will be reducing number of instances. So we stay by only three character. So if these are 60 character, our first sequence, then this is our next sequence, right? And then this will be our next sequence, and so on. So we actually stay by three character because I want a lot of data. So we actually tell model, if this is the sequence, next character this space. If this is the sequence, next character this space. If this is the sequence, next character is A. If this is the sequence, next character is G, and so on. So we actually need to create sequences of certain length from text and see in the actual data what is the next character after that sequence. Because ultimately, when we are testing the model, we'll give it condition in text and we'll predict the next character. If our model has learned how to predict next character, then it should be able to, learn from the data to give us probability of what should be the next character on that sequence. Right? Do you understand that?
Yes, sir. But So means the selection of sequence and step size is crucial.
These are hyperparameters. If you have lot of data, if you have load of data, then your sequence size might be longer. But if you've got very small data set, then your sequence size should be small. Because smaller the sequence size, more you will have instances. But longer the sequence size, lower you will have number of instances, number of possibilities, number of X's. So if you have got very small data set, then keep sequence size small. If you have got sufficiently large data set, you can keep sequence size longer. That also depends in real time how long sequences you want to generate. Right. So see here, I first import as usual.
Sir?
Yes, Irfan.
Sir, but for larger sequences, context window will be higher.
You should not say context window. I mean, here we just want, if you say, for example, one that your machine should generate a one pager text. Now, you know that in one page, you will be needing, say, for example, 5,000 characters. You might ask your, you know, LSTM that generate 5,000 character. When you say generate 5,000 character, you will give it some conditioning text, some initial text, maybe 5 character, maybe 10 character, and then from there on, it will extend those 5-10 characters to 50,000 characters. I mean, depends on your requirement. Let's see this example. You will get more idea of it, right? So first of all, I do nothing. I just, you know, import Keras NumPy from Keras utilities. We have got get file. We say we want this file, which is available on this URL, right? And then we say take is equal to open this path, read and convert all these in lowercase, right? I mean, beauty of Python. Then we print the corpus length, which is 600,901. These are actually, you know, more than 6 lakh. Yes, more than 6 lakh. Eh? So 600,901 characters. So these are the number of characters in this text. It is actually this note, Nietzsche. You call it Nietzsche. Nietzsche is a philosopher. I mean, my God, he gave a lot of theories. He was German. If you want to read about Nietzsche, he and Kant, K-A-N-T, and you know, a couple of other guys, they were contemporary, and they, you know, gave a lot of meanings to life. If you want to read up more about it, I refer a lot of books of Bertrand Russell. You just Google Bertrand Russell, his books, and then he actually talked about Nietzsche. So he was a very good philosopher. He gave a lot of meaning to life. Anyway, this is a whole, you know, text from this book, and we will be training our model on this text. Right. Let's see how we are generating sequences from here. Imported. We say maximum sequence length is 60. It means that every sequence will be of 60 character. So the first sequence, character 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, space means 8, right? Then 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, suppose up to here. So suppose these are the 60 characters. So this will be our first sequence. And then if this is input, what should be output, Nimra? If this is input, what should be output?
Sir, the next 60 characters. The next 60 characters.
This is
character. I think comma.
So what will be next output, Haseeb?
I think comma, sir.
Comma. So we say that we are training model that after philosophers and before all these words, if you ask me what should be next character, model should tell me comma. Right. So if this is the next sequence and we reach here, maybe these are the 60 characters, the next character should be n. So our first step is to prepare the data set. Data set means input sequences and output character. Input sequences and output character. Input sequences and output character. Right. If we train model on this input and output, it should be able to generate any size of sequence. Let's see how we are doing it. We say maximum length is 60 and our step is 3. Our step is 3. It means that our first sequence starts from here. If these are 60 characters, then the next sequence will start from here. Right? Step 3. It means leave these 3 characters. The third sequence will start from here. And so on. Right? Let's see how we are doing it. So maximum length is 60. Step is 3. Sentences, whatever sequences we will extract, we will keep in sentences, and whatever next characters are there after these sequences, we'll keep those in next character. So you can say these are our X's and these are our Y's. Do you want me to take break for Azan?
Yes, sir. For Azan in Namaz.
Okay. 10 minutes, you are at home. So only 10 minutes, you can come back at 5:45. Okay. 5:50. Come back at 5:50. We will resume from here.
Okay, sir.
I'm not going to leave Zoom. I will leave Zoom open so you can come back immediately.
Right. Yes, thank you, sir.
Welcome back, guys. I hope you are here.
Yes, sir.
Okay. I hope you can see my screen.
Yes, sir. We can see.
Okay. 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 So, Irfan, are you there? Irfan, are you there? Abdullah, are you there?
So, shall I message that group?
No, I have. Let me. I think I said 5:50, so it is 5:49. Maybe they are very punctual.
I'm back, sir.
Okay. Okay, so are you there, Kainat?
Yes, sir.
Manisha, are you there?
Yes, sir.
Okay, thank you, beta. So we are going to resume. So you got the broad idea. So we have text. We want to break it in sequence, each of length 60, and we'll stay by 3 character. The reason being, we want too many sequences. All the sequences that will be extracting from the text will keep in sentences, and their next character will keep in next character. Right. So here is the logic. For I in range 0 to length of the text minus, maximum length. So we will run through the text from character 0 till, all characters minus 60. Right. So we'll start from here and we end till here. Right. So maybe if I say these are the 60 characters, we will stop here. Right. Because after that, we cannot stay. Right? So if these are 60 characters, if I have to stay by 3, I obviously cannot stay from here because that will not be 60 characters. So we'll stop just 60 characters before end of the document. Right. Okay, then we say sentence dot append text I colon I plus maximum length. So you can see here we are actually starting from 0 and 0 plus 60. So the first sequence will be from 0 to 60. It means that first 60 character. And what should be the output for this? The next character dot append. Next character at I plus 60 means that exactly the 60th character. So 0 to 59, these were the first 60 character. And then we say the 61st character we are keeping here. So we say if that is the input, then this should be its corresponding output. Right. Let us just display it. Maybe if I do, say for example, let's do this and then this, right? So this will give me all the sequences, and say for example, I'm doing nothing. I just say that print say for example sentences at 0, right? You can see 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 into this space. 8, 9 up to, this is character number 59. Huh? Is there? So the character number 60, you can see here, is there, T-H, right? So is T-H-E. So what do you think? If I print, if I print next characters at 0, Haseeb, what do you think? What this should print?
0, sir, the 60th character which we extracted means R. If E was the 59th character, so it will be R.
Okay.
Yeah.
That's good. We can see there is R. Right. So if I display the first sequence, you know, three characters have been eliminated. We are stepping by three. So you can see it was three phase. Now it starts from here, phase. Right. And this sequence, obviously, previously we ended here. So add three more characters. So it should end here. Right. It should end here. You can see it is ending here. Obviously, just one space. Right. So after that one space, what should be next character? N. So here we have N. You can see there we have N. Right. So this actually shows that this logic, we are actually reading 60 characters at a time, and then we actually keep what is the next character of that sequence. We are actually kind of preparing model. We say, if you see the sequence, the next character prediction should be this. If you see the sequence, next character prediction should be this, and so on. Right. Now, we have got input and we have got output. We want to see how many should be output of this network. Certainly, the output of network should be all the unique characters that we have in text. Right. So here I say characters sort list say text. So from text, I actually kind of list all the characters that I have in the text, all the characters that I have in the text. And because it is set, so these will be unique values. So actually in characters, I get all unique characters. I just display it. So this will actually display all the unique characters. The next step that I'm going to do, I actually kind of create a dictionary, and in that dictionary to each character, I will actually give it a number, right? And that number actually starts from 0 to maximum number of characters that I have, right? So I actually create a dictionary which gives each character an index, right? And let's display things up to this. Maybe if I do this, if I comment out these so that we can understand, right? I do nothing. I just print character indices, right? I print character indices. So we get all unique character, and to each character through this loop, I'm going to give an index, and then I display that index. Let's see how many unique characters are there. So this says that number of sequences are, you know, more than 200,281. It means that we will have 200,281 inputs, right? And output is 59. I mean, number of unique, instances. These will be more than 200,000. And the number unique characters in this data set are 59, right? 59 because there is a new line, there is zero, there is one, there is exclamation. We have two, three, four, semicolon, we have actually created a dictionary. So this is given zero, space is given one, this is given two, because this is dictionary, a quotation is given three, and single quotation is given four, and so on. So we have got 59 unique character, and to each character, we are giving a unique number. Right. Now, once if this is done, the next step that we are going to do, is to do one-hot encoding to our input and output. Right. Now, this is quite important. See here, what I'm doing. I say x equal to your numpy zero, number of, the first, this is three dimension. Eh? So the first dimension is number of sequences, and how many sequences we have? More than 200,000. So the first dimension will be 200,281, right? And each of them will be a matrix. Eh? Each of these sequences will be a matrix, and that matrix has got maximum length, which is 60. It means that 60 rows, and how many columns? The number of unique characters, which means that 59. So we will have more than 200,000 matrices. Each of the matrix will be 60 row and 59 column. 60 row, why? Because we have got 60 characters in each of the sentence, in each of the sequence. And why 59? Because we have got 59 unique characters. Right. Okay. Then so we create this x and then we create y. Y is actually length of the sentences, right? And then you know number of characters. So length of the sentences means these 200,281, right? Which is the same as this one. And then you know each length of the character, which is 59, right? So we have got input sequences in x and their corresponding label in y. Now we say for I sentence in enumerate, we enumerate sentences. So in I we get the index and the actual sentence we get in sentence. And then for t character enumerate sentence, we are going to get one character at a time from the sentence. And then we say x at I, which is initially zero. It means that on zeroth sequence at t and character index character equal to one, right? So you can see here, it is just like we are going to create the first matrix. There will be such, 200,000 matrices, more than 200,000 matrices. So outer loop will run for 0 to 200,280, right? 0 to 200,280. And then, you know, the inner loop, we are actually setting values for each of the sequence. So the first sentence, the first sequence that we will be extracting, you know, it will have these, you know, 60 characters. These are the 60 characters. So the first row will be representing P, second row will represent R, third row will represent E, fourth row will represent F, fifth row A, sixth row C, and seventh row E. Right. Let's just display one of these. You will get better idea. If I do this vectorization, and then if say for example I'm going to print x zeroth sequence, and I want to print the first matrix. So see, you can see here it has displayed this, right? Why this? Because the first character is P. Now what is the value for P? The value for P in our dictionary is H11OPPPP is 42. It means that this starts from 0 to, you know, 659. So 41 character should be true, because this is the first character in the sequence. So the first character is represented by, you know, as one hot encoded, all false except what is being represented by P, which is 42. 42 here means 41st index. So you can see here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So these are 12, these will be 24, these will be 36, then 37, 38, 39, 40, 41, 42, 43. Why 43? Yeah, 43. Because the address for P is 42. The 43rd element. And it starts. So that's right. It means that this is the first row in the sequence which represents the character.
P.
Right. Okay, great. Now see. Okay. Nimra, what do you think? What is this character?
Sir, what text? Can you please display the text?
No, I don't need to display the text. You just see where is true, and wherever it is true.
Okay, sir. Sir, isko itna chota hai. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, and here. 29, 27 kahan gaya? Sir, itna chota chota likha hai ispe. 27. Sir, here.
Sahi hai? 27 A. Yani ki hamare in our actual text the fourth character should be A. So first.
No sir, it's not A.
Another fifth, because four.
Yeah. See, it start with zero, na?
So this is actually four. This is actually eight.
Yeah.
You're right. Yeah. This should be.
Yes, sir.
Right. If I say, for example, I just want to get rid of this guy. I mean, yeah, all space. I want to start from here. So maybe if I display another sequence, maybe sentence. Okay. I say print sentences. Sentences. Okay. If I print sentences at 10, sentences. Right. Come on.
S-E-N.
Sentences. Right. So is a woman. Is okay to start from here, right? And it ends at is a woman ground should be ending here as no suspecting T. We are suspecting, okay? So is woman and suspecting, right? It ends here, right? It means it is this sequence. So this is sequence number 10. Now, this is sequence number 10, if I want to display print x sequence number 10 and 0, sequence number 10, 0. So you can see sequence number 10 and maybe 1. So you can see where is true. It is here, right? So 12, 24.
36.
This is 36, but this is 35. Right? 35. So 30.
Yeah, it should be 35.
Yeah. Means I. 35 means I. So the second character should be I, and that's right, because this sequence starts with the space and then I. So second, the first character is I, right? So the second character is actually I, because I have written one deliberately because I knew that there will be a space, right? So you can see we have vectorized x. When we vectorized x, it means that we have got more than 200,000 sequences, exactly 200,281 sequences, and each of the sequence is actually, 60 rows and 59 columns. 60 rows because there are 60 characters, and 59 columns because there are 59 unique characters in this data set. So we vectorize x, and now we vectorize y. How we vectorize y? We say y at I, character index is next character at I is equal to 1. So whatever character we get on that particular location, we say equal to 1, everything else is equal to 0. Because this is also 60 by 59, right? So we only turn 1 to the character which is appearing. So this is how we actually vectorize x and y. We vectorize x and y, it is neural network, so we need to do it. Right. Have you understood the whole concept? Have you understood how we created x and y? Have you understood that what is our x and what is our y? Irfan, yes, go ahead, ask question.
Yes, sir. We vectorize this using Boolean, but for neural network, we provide zeros and ones, right? Yeah.
These are one and zero. Don't worry. I mean, Python will consider false one and false zero and true one. So these are again one and zeros.
Okay.
Any other question? Okay, thank you. So we have created our x and we have created our y. Our x is sequence and our y is what should be next character. Now we build our network. So a network is simple, sequential, output 128. Input shape is equal to maximum length 60 and length of character, the number unique character 59, right? So we will be every time giving one sequence at a time, and our one sequence means 60 rows and 59 character, right? We add another layer, the output layer. You can see we add a dense layer, the output is softmax, and how many output? How many 59. Output?
59.
Come on. I wanted to ask this from Manisha. Just wanted to check if she is, with us. Manisha, what should be output of this layer, this network?
sir, output or number of rows?
The output of this network, what should be output?
Sir, the length of character, that is 59.
How many characters we have, unique characters?
59, sir.
59, very good, very good. So we'll give input sequence at the input of the network, and we will ask network, what do you think, what should be next character? Right, okay, great, excellent. It means that if we give these X's to the network and these Y's to the network, it will have sufficient learning. Huh? It will have very good learning. It will understand that after this, I need to produce A. It will understand that after this, I need to produce A. It will understand that after producing this, I need to produce L, and so on. Right, so we have prepared X's, we have prepared Y's, and we give these to the network. You can see it is still, you know, same network as we do in classification. The only change is number of input and number of output. And here, number of output is 59 because unique characters are 59. Great. We then, it is still a classification problem. It is still a classification problem. Huh? Because, you know, LSTM gives at the output layer the probabilities. You know, softmax actually converts output into probabilities. So we will get probabilities. So in a way, network will give us these values. Network will give us these values, right? We compile it, learning rate, compile, you know, categorical cross entropy, optimizer is this, right? The next thing is sampling. The next thing is sampling. You know, we say, we call the sample method, we give predictions, the prediction that we'll get from neural network, temperature is equal to 1. If you are not passing value of temperature, then default value is 1. Then we say prediction is equal to numpy.array, prediction.stypefloat 64, prediction np.log, we give, you know, we calculate log of prediction divide by temperature, right? This is state, huh? Log of prediction and divide by temperature, right? So we perform this, and then second is, you know, exponent of each prediction, this is straight, right? When we calculate exponent, then we divide it by, sum of these. The reason is, otherwise they exceed 1, and we want probability values, so we have to limit them to sum of 1. So we actually, you know, divide all of them by sum of all these values, right? And then we do multinomial. Huh? We say perform one experiment. If you can recall your probability lesson, multinomial is actually multiple experiments. How many times you want to repeat? You give them, some constant probabilities. So it will actually draw some random values from those experiments. So we say, for example, if you are drawing a dice, and you say, if say for multinomial, I need to explain this to you, otherwise this concept will not be clear on you. Multinomial, say for example, if I say you are drawing the dice, I say perform 10 experiments, right? So out of 10 experiments, I mean draw it for 10 times, throw it for 10 times. I can say 3 times I saw 1, 2 times I saw 2, and 5 times I saw 3, huh? And 0 times I saw this, 0 times I saw this, 0 times I saw this, and so on. Obviously, it has to be summed to 10. So 5, 7, and 10. So this is, you know, you actually threw dice for 10 times, and each time the probability is constant. Then what will be selected? So initially, 3 times 1 was selected, 2 times 2 was selected, and 5 times 3 was selected. Right. Now, the second argument here is, do you want to repeat that experiment? So you say, I repeated this experiment, and next time I actually saw, say for example, these probabilities, right? So we say that in first attempt, in second attempt. So this is a multinomial experiment. So here, we actually say perform this once and do not repeat it, right? And draw probabilities randomly from these predictions. So you know that it will actually will get probabilities, and I send the one which is maximum. Right? I send the one which is maximum. So say, for example, out of these 59, whichever will be chosen highest number of time, it will be sent back where it has been called from. The whole idea is we just want to disturb these probabilities, because if we do not disturb, then your network will be very predictable. We actually want it to be unpredictable. We want it to be unpredictable because we want that it should be generating new text. If we do not make it unpredictable, then it will always be generating same text which it has seen, which means that it will not be creative. It will only be, you know, copy pasting from its history, and that is what we do not want. So that is the reason why we are doing this sampling. Right. Okay, now see here what we are doing. We actually run for 60 epochs, and we see every time what text we are generating. We say model.fit, our model, the one which we have compiled here. So we say during each epoch, right, model.fit, we give x, we give y. You know what is our x and y. Batch size is 128, you know why. The number of epochs, every time we are performing only one, we are training model for one epoch, right? Okay, start, now we are going to generate sequences. We say start index equal to random dot random int 0 till length of text minus maximum length minus 1. You know what we are doing here? We are actually seeing that we are randomly choosing a starting point for our seed text. You can call it seed text, or you can call it conditioning text, right? So here, when you saw this, this was my seed text. The cat sat on the M. Now, where this text will come from? I mean, why not get this text from our original data? What I'm doing, I'm actually saying that from this text, I will be randomly pointing finger somewhere. Maybe here. So I actually generate a random index, right? So we say that start index is equal to, and I'm giving it the, you know, length from zero till 60 characters before end of the document, because I need 60 characters sequence. So for that reason, obviously I cannot have an index which is at the last character of document. From there I cannot generate text. So that is the reason why I say generate a random index from 0 till 60 character before end of the document. So we generate random index and then generated text equal to, I get from my text, the original text, start index, what I've just generated, how many characters, start index plus maximum length. So maximum length in our case is 60. So we will be generating 60 characters at random. Those will be picked from here. So say, for example, if we end up here, and maybe these are 60 characters. These are 60 characters. So this sequence, which we are using as a seed, we display here, and then we see what network generates on temperature 2, on temperature 0.5, on temperature 1, and temperature 1.2. So we print temperature here, we display the text, right? And we say for I in range 400, sample equal to, we are generating 400 samples. So these 60 characters will be concatenated with another 400 characters, that I will be generating one character at a time. And that character I'll be concatenating with my seed. So you can see here, sampled equal to numpy.0, 1 maximum length, and length of character, I call this, I just generate this matrix, and that matrix is just one sequence. Maximum length means 60 character, and then unique characters which are 59. So for T and character enumerate generated text, I get one character at a time. So zero t and character add character equal to one. So I'm actually returning those one which are appearing in my generated text. Then you can see here, I say model dot predict sampled this one and temperature. Sample, I do not want to display it. I just send it to my model. So I prepare this sequence. I give the sequence which I have generated. So this is the sequence. I'm vectorizing it. After vectorizing, I give it to the model. I say, give me prediction. When it gives me prediction, I send that prediction with current temperature value initially 0.2 to the sample method. You know what it is doing? It returns me the next character. So I get a next character which I actually concatenate with my generated sequence. Right, and next time my generated sequence, my generated text equal to generated text one and colon, because I want to move the frame. I want to move frame one character at a time. So initially, if I end up here, if these are 60 characters, next time I give this sequence. Next time I give, this sequence, and so on. So maybe, so that every time I'm giving new sequence to my model, right? And then I just display the next character which has been generated. I just flush it, go back next time, display the generated text, and then generate next text, concatenate, do it for 400 character. Right? And I end when 400 character has been generated for 0.2, then for 0.5, then for 1.0, and then for 1.2. Right? You will get an idea when you see output. You can see here, epoch 1. Model has been trained only on one epoch. It is still not very, good model, right? Inside, you can see here, I fit on the model, generating with seed. So initially I have generated this one. E of Benny put observe and same. You can see we generated initially this sequence. E space off. So I can see E space off. So yeah, E of benefit. So we randomly ended here and up to same, right? Up to here, right? So same feeling in other mutual. Okay, up to mutual. So E. Up to mutual, right? So this was the initial sequence generated. 60 characters, these were generated. If you see, the next character is space, but let's see what it has generated. So you can see on temperature 0.02, we actually generated these next 400 characters. We gave 60 characters and we say generate another 400 characters. So you can see these are the 400 characters that model has generated. So you can see some of the words are E space off, very correct, very, a word that is grammatically correct. E of benefit and observer the same feeling in other mutually and the self for the contemplate to a spirit to the self. In the alterity and still and more in calamity. You can see sentences are not making sense, but words have been generated, and some of those words are correct words. So at least our model has been able to generate benefit. It has been able to generate and observe same. Obviously, some of the words are incorrect. Or maybe E does not exist. Maybe reads historical conduct. I don't know if this word exists in dictionary. Some of the words which it has generated, they are very new. They may not be in this whole, text, but they are still correct word, right? When we increase temperature, you can see, a lot of synthetic should have been added. You will see that the quality will be better because randomization is better. When you are at 0.5, the randomization is at best. So you can see here, and the future and desire, and most subject the contradict helper consideration to mean. You can see these words never existed in dictionary, but even these words have been generated. It any palted should would the self in the will to itself and with of props and so on. Right, temperature one, these will be very, you know, very random, extremely random. You can see true with the self is still a fine manifest and so on. So you increase the temperature value, higher will be the randomization. So you can see when randomization is increased, even words are not making sense. You can see this word, this is not a word in English, huh? M-I-U-N-T, algo, good, you know, all these words, when you increase the temperature value, they are extremely random. Because when you see this, when you see temperature versus randomization, you can see higher the temperature, higher the randomization. Here, low value of temperature, extremely predictable. Probably creativity will be very low. But as you increase temperature, when you reach to 0.5, probably that is a good randomization value. But if you increase it further, it will be extremely random. There, even the words which are generated may not be making a lot of sense. But the good thing is, on this text, we have trained the model, and model is generating words which are from the novel or may not be from this document. You know, completely new words, right? May it contemple, always conscient, consigned, inclines, you know, a lot of words has been, you know, formulated by the LSTM, which some of them are meaningful words from dictionary and others are really not the words from dictionary. I mean, just imagine if you are teaching your kid to make a word from character, initially it will be just jumbling, you know, characters and making a word which will have no meaning. But as his learning, you know, upgrades, he will be eventually concatenating words, concatenating character to make a word which might be from dictionary, right? Same is the case with the LSTM, right? So maybe when you train it more, it will perform better. On first epoch, that was the result. But if you come down, now its result on 0.5 should be very good. On temperature 0.2, on temperature 0.2, after 47 epochs, you can see temperature 0.5, this one, eh? E, strong and such philosophers in the strong and spirit of soul and surfeit decide classify word to an earth which is delusion. An earth which is delusion. Really philosophical, eh? Of the surfeiment and development of spirits is to the greater with the state from reality, you know, supremely is all the fact and so on. Right. If you even go further, why it has stopped? It should be still training. Epoch 50. Okay, maybe I should run it again or what? Model. I need to compile. So these were the previous outputs. Eh? So you can see as we train model more, the quality of generated text will certainly will improve. Let's run this model. It won't take a lot of time because we are still processing text. It won't take a lot of time. But the bottom line is, more you train the model, better it will be performing. I'm running it on my local machine, but if you run it on CoLab, you might see, you know, better speed. Right. So the whole idea is sequence, next character, sequence, next character, sequence, next character. You just train the model. And then when you do the prediction, here we are not doing any testing. Eh? Remember, we are not testing. This is not a classification. Here, we train the model and then we do prediction. And how we are doing prediction? We say that from the model, you can see model.predict. We give it the sequence which we have prepared. You can see we generated sequence, we vectorized the sequence, and we give that sequence to the model, and we say, do not display it. These predictions we are sending to sample so that we can introduce some randomization. And whatever we get from there, that corresponding character we are getting from our character array, which is actually array of unique characters, right? And that generated, you know, character we are going to concatenate with our text, and then we do it for, you know, another 400 times so that we can generate 400 more characters. So in this case, you can see as model grows older, on first epoch it may not be very good, on 50th epoch it will give you a lot of synthetic contents, at 100th epochs maybe it is as wise as our grandfather, so the words that it will be generating will be carrying some wisdom, there will be some meaningful words, right? So till the model gets trained, we can take few questions. Yes, Irfan, you can ask question. I can see your hand raised before anyone else. Yes, go ahead.
Yes, sir. How you are validating that generated text characters actually is belonging to a language? And second thing, sir, how this model is training himself? I mean, itself. I mean, are we feeding back that generated character back to the model to validate that?
No. See here, Irfan, for assessing the quality of generated text, obviously we do not have any accuracy formula here. You can see accuracy means when we are so here we cannot have accuracy as a matrix for assessing quality of generated text. So obviously some new metrics were required when we were generating text. So for that reason, they actually introduced Blue, BLEU, and ROUGE, ROUGE. These actually kind of do the comparison between original text and the generated text. More the overlapping, higher is the accuracy. Low the overlapping, lower is the quality of generated text. I will cover Blue, maybe when we are covering Transformer and GPT, at that stage I will cover Blue. But BLEU is one good metric to assess quality of generated text, because you cannot check accuracy of generated text. It's not classification. I mean, you cannot check accuracy. So you actually check quality of generated text. So for that, they have introduced Blue, which has got some mathematics, which actually tells you if the generated text is of the quality or not. And it ranges from 0 to 100. So 0 means it is pathetic, completely random. It is not, you know, synthetic. So when the quality is 100, it means that it is completely new text, but it looks very original text, right? So this person does not exist. I will give 100 to the new faces, because they never existed, but they still look like actual faces. So the text which is of 100 Blue, it means that text is of the quality text and it is not from the original corpus, right?
Sir, but sir, the first slide which we saw, there was a link. The model was generating some output and we were feeding that back to another iteration. Where that link establishing in this code? I'm not getting the.
I'm not feeding that to the model. I'm feeding that as an input to
the model. Slide number three, sir. Slide number three.
Slide number three in my, you know, PPTs.
Yes, sir.
Slide number three. This one. Yes. Yes. What we are doing? Sir. Here we actually send first this, right?
Right.
Then I can remove T and then H, E, and then M, A. So we are every time the input to the model is of 60, you know, character. You can see here every time the generated text initially we generate text. Initially generated text equal to from the original text start index, which is random value, start index till start index plus maximum length. And the value of maximum length is 60, right? So initially I generate a random sequence of 60 character. I give that to my model and I say do the prediction. Do the prediction. Right? Because you know what is sample? Sample is the sequence. And what is sample? All the characters which we have in the generated text. In the generated text. Right? So generated text is actually sequence that we are giving to the model, and we say predict next character. Remember, model has been trained. We have given him all the X's from that text document and their corresponding Y. So now we are giving it a sequence. That sequence model may or may not have seen in past. हो सकता है कि उसने देखी हो सकता है उसने ना देखी हो क्योंकि ये भी पॉसिबिलिटी है ना ये देखे if you randomly ended here and if you say this is my sequence there is a probability that this sequence model has seen and there is a probability this sequence model has not seen you know why because we are escaping by 3 you can see here my first yes, sequence sir. Is this one my second sequence is this one huh this sequence was missed this sequence model is not seen are you getting my point
yes sir
huh? So the yes. first generated text that you are generating randomly you actually take as is from the text you vectorize it after vectorizing you actually ask the model to do the prediction you can see here you actually give that sequence to the model to predict now what this prediction will be these will be probabilities for 59 characters so those probabilities I mean we do not end here when we are doing classification we end here but now we are not doing classification we are doing text prediction so we do not end here we actually send this prediction to sample it will you know disturb the probabilities it gives us the probability for the highest you know probable character but that was not the probability we got from LST this is the probability we have actually done we have done some jumbling with temperature value so the highest probability for the character now we get may not be same as predicted by LSTM because we do want some you know creativity so but for that reason we actually jumble all these probabilities we actually disturb these probabilities and then get the character on that value and this next character is being concatenated and Irfan see this line this yes, line sir, now says, this line says generated text is equal to generated text ignore zeros right so first if we say for example if we started from here right so now we will start from here then we will start from here then we will start from here then we will start from here and so on right so every time in text we are shifting one character at a time one character at a time when you are training three character at a time right so here yeah. obviously the idea is your input sequence should be of 60 characters so that is the requirement so we actually generate you know start index and then generated text is equal to from start index next 60 characters next 60 characters so we actually generate initial seed text of 60 characters so that 60 character we vectorize after vectorization we get prediction after prediction we you know sample it do the sampling strategy and then get next character concatenate and shift one character to the right next time when you come you have to generate next character and remember how many characters we are generating 400 characters you can see here do it for 400 times so one character at a time concatenating in that and when 400 characters have been generated do the next epoch right so every epoch we are training the model and then doing the prediction when in epoch 1 this is epoch inside the loop right model has been trained right and then you know we started from here is allowed himself to be now this must be the text from the rather this one which one this one this must be text from the document is a space allowed himself to be persuaded to self denial in the reeli so we actually get this whole text reeli wow model model predicts AL, right? Then model predicts space. Then model predicts I in space there. You can see because temperature value is low, so model is very predictable. So a lot of words which is it is generating, they are exactly same words, or maybe even sequence of word is probably same as in the actual text. There will be some randomization. I mean, you will see that exactly this text will not be in the actual text, but maybe long, quite long sequences will be from the text because temperature size is 0.2. But when you increase temperature, you can see a lot of randomization is there. And now the text which is appearing in the generated text, it is quite new text, right? So you can see here, this process we continue for 400 characters. Now we have reached epoch 4 and so on. Right. So have you got the whole idea?
Yes, sir.
Guys, if you have any query.
Sir, we will perform some experiments. Then
Seth, we can start with Seth and then we'll move to Nimra. Seth, go ahead.
Sir, I have no query, but I want to say that we will perform some experiments and we'll do the assignments. Then we will, it will be more clear.
That's right. That's very right. Nimra, go ahead.
So basically, I have 3-4 questions. One question was same, which Irfan asked. And from your answer, I just understood K means we want to generate 400 characters. And from that 400 characters, 60 are taken from the text, which is predefined, right? And after 60th index, we start taking the generated text, which is generated by the model, right?
That's right.
Okay. Sir, my question now is that if we don't have any method to assess which one is, which one is more creative and which is also right, so how we can identify the value of temperature, which value of temperature is good for our model? I'm not getting this.
Means validating the model.
Yeah.
Good text is correct.
Nimra.
Validating the gains.
Yes, sir.
Nimra, when you have temperature value of 0.5, model will be creative. When I'm saying model will be creative, I mean that it will be generating new text. Right. When temperature value is quite low, or like maybe 0.01, model will be very predictable. It will be generating same text which it has seen before. And if the temperature value is 1, model will be completely random. Model will be completely random, like a 1 year old kid which is just have learned recently alphabet and combining A with Z with D with A. Baba, see how good I have written. At that stage, when temperature value is 1, model will be completely random. Its prediction will be very ununderstandable. Random, but ununderstandable. 0.0 or 0.1, model will be very predictable. Text will be correct, but that will not be new text. There will be very zero creativity. Right? So that is the reason why they say you should choose temperature value 0.5, because there you will have an element of randomness, but you will also have some element of creativity. Because if you see the formula, the mathematics of this, you can see here, temperature 0.01 always predictable, this will be the next character, and temperature 1.0, lot of characters are there, we don't know which will be chosen. But if temperature is 0.6 or 0.5, a lot of characters are competing, but they are still, differentiable. They are still not as random as they are here. So that is the reason why they say you should be choosing temperature value around 0.5. But again, this is hyperparameter. I'm not saying that this is the ideal value. In some cases, you may get more creative contents at 0.8 or maybe 0.4 or maybe 0.3. Again, it's a hyperparameter. You need to adjust it based on your experiments. Nimra, more question?
It completely depends on the experiment. Sir, the last one, the window size. Means here the window size was 60. Then means how we decide the window size? Is there any criteria or not? That's it.
Nimra, if you have got a lot of, then the size of your sequence, you can call it window size. It can be long. Like here, I had, you know, more than lot of text was there. So we actually selected window size 60, right? But if you have got very few instances, if you've got low number of instances in your input data set, then if your sequence size is long, your number of pixels will be very low. Because you need to understand that longer the sequence size, lower will be number of pixels. Shorter the sequence size, higher will be number of pixels. Point number one. Point number two, okay, you might have a very low sequence size, but then you also need to understand that in real world, how long are your sentences? Your sentences are generally, long sentences. You can see here, if I randomly open any website, you can see here, if I say my sequence size is 3, it means that you are training your model on just one word. After
each word,
you want to see what is the next character. The model learning will be very limited. Will be very limited. But if you say that your model should see sentences, then you say maybe sequence size is this one. You can see how long is your sentence. You can see here, sentence is quite long. This whole paragraph is just one sentence. You can see how many characters are there. So you will see that longer the sentence in your data set, higher should be the sequence size. But if you see smaller are the sentences, then small should be your sequence size. Again, it's a trade-off. Because if you reduce sequence size, you can increase number of instances, which will help you to enrich your model, to increase the data set size. But again, the drawback is if your sequence is too small, then your model may never see sentences. It will be trained on
context. Word. Context will be missed. Yeah. Sorry,
sir. It will be unable to understand the context. Right.
Yes.
Again, it's a kind of hyperparameter that you need to decide based on your own data sets.
Fine, sir. Thank you, sir.
Okay. More questions, guys, if you have.
No, sir.
Okay. Good. Khalid, are you clear? Khalid?
Yes, sir.
Okay, good. Kainat?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Clear.
Abdullah Sumro?
Yes, sir, it's clear.
Okay, good. And Abdullah?
Yes, sir.
Okay, great.
All clear.
Okay. Excellent. Now, if you read assignment, I think you can make better sense of it. Now, if you read assignment, you can make better sense of it. You can see here, up to this point, train LSTM. It is same as we have been doing throughout the semester. Train LSTM models separately for each class label and generate enough sample for each label to balance the data set. You need to, give at least 20-25 hours to do this assignment. Do not take it for granted.
20-25 hours.
Yeah, in order to develop understanding to, it is not that you will only be updating few variable in my code and then you say, I can generate samples for joy, for surprise, for sad. No, you cannot do that. You need to spend a lot of time. So be aware of that. I'm just warning you that this assignment is not 1 hour assignment. This is probably 2 hour assignment. So give time tomorrow, day after tomorrow, day after tomorrow, and so. Okay, so we end this text generation here. I want to teach, I know that some of you might be very curious to learn text image generation. Generative deep learning. By the
next
way,
class, sir.
I also want you guys to do this. Can you extend it to make word label generation? Here we were generating one character at a time. Now can you generate one?
Okay. Yes, sir, we can do that.
Manisha, you have a question? Manisha?
But it's not easy to do this. How we will decide the length of a word? I mean, a word can be of 3 characters, a word can be of 5 characters, and so on.
the longest word in your data set. The longest word in your data set, or
but see, word. Sir, there is also an issue. If you decide the longest word, then how it will generate the smaller words? I mean, every time it will generate the word of that number of characters, the length.
Those which are not appearing, they will be null. They will be null. So say for example, if I say that the output size of your document should be maybe say for example 10, huh? 10, maybe 10, right?
Right.
Okay, maybe 26, because unique alphabet character, the which word is appearing, if say for example it is cat. Now for cat, for example, in dictionary, the dictionary that you are maintaining, it is three. So you will say that, 0, 1, 2, 3. This should be 1, everything else should be 0. The word, previously, you know, C was given, C was given 3, but now every word is being given an index. This is one way of doing it. The second way of doing it, the character that you are generating, the word that you are generating is actually having length, which is length of the biggest word or the longest word in your corpus. So the longest word in your corpus is, say for example, I say elephant, right? Elephant means A-L-E-P-H-A-N-T, elephant, right? Now we say for example, this is the longest word, elephant, E-L-E-P-H-A-N-T. Right, this is the longest word. Say for example, this is the longest word. If this is the longest word,
sir, we cannot do by this, I think.
You can do see, that.
If this is the longest word may have characters which may not be available in other words. Like in this case, elephant. So from this, how can we generate a cat? I mean, this doesn't have C in it.
Sir, we will study. It's our assignment.
Sir, I got the idea. I got the idea.
Yeah. Do it. I mean, you just read a couple of tutorials. You should be able to do it. I've already done it. I know that you have to trust me. I have already done it.
Okay, sir. We trust you,
sir.
Irfan, Gandho, Zain, Pani. Irfan, Gandho, Pani.
Sir, do we have to make word level and character level as well? Yeah.
We have. I mean, sometimes word level. I mean, in GPT-2, they usually do it word level, not the character level. Because they say that when you're doing it character level, it generates words which are meaningless. But if you're doing it word level, all the words will be meaningful.
What about sentence level, sir?
A sentence level will be too much predictable. We are generating same sentences which are from the original, text. So they say do it at word level. So word level is more, creative than sentence level, and more accurate than character level. Because in character level, you will have sometimes meaningless character. But here, at least when you're doing word level, all the words will be meaningful. Here you can see my model is generating some words which are not correct. Some words which are not correct. Right. So you can see here it has greatest, we deal as in his victims speak. Probably this is a temperature 0.2 because this is too predictable. So it is generating correctly. But if you go at 1.2, my God, generation will be very pathetic. You can see now, have you ever seen this word? Can you even pronounce it?
No, sir.
Restriction.
Okay. Nimra, can you pronounce this one?
Kale Dangrezi Padna.
Sir, I am unable to read it. This is
tiny on my laptop. On my tiny laptop.
Right. So you can see higher the temperature value, higher the randomness, and when there is too much randomness, quality actually goes down. But when you're doing it at word level, then the words that you'll be generating, they will be very much correct. Because you are here, you can see character has not been corrupted. Here, all the characters are correct, but words are incorrect. Because characters are formulating words. So when you are doing it at word level, words will be correct. Sentences may not be meaningful. But again, it depends. Yes?
Sir, but again, we have to verify those words from the dictionary or the corpus of text on which you are training.
Right. All the unique so words.
If we do it from the corpus we are training, then there will be no innovation in it, creativity. More often than less, it will be just changing the sequences and giving a new word.
Irfan, see here.
Sir.
If I'm saying my GPT-2 or my LSTM to write an article on sports, then I should not train it on whole Wikipedia text. Because if it is trained on Wikipedia, then it must have also learned 18th Amendment, army, pistol, killing. These words are not in a sports world. So if you want that your model should be writing article on sports, train it on sports vocabulary. Do not show him word pistol. Do not show him word 18th Amendment. Because these are the words which you are not using in a sports article. So that, I mean, okay, if by chance they are appearing, maybe out of 1 million words, only one time you see 18th Amendment, probability is very low that your model will be generating 18th Amendment. But the thing is, even in your assignment, I have given you this guidance that train LSE models separately for each class level. Because see here, the important thing is, words tell you which class label as tweet belongs to. When I'm saying today I'm extremely happy, you know, word happy is telling me that this tweet belongs to joy. But if I say when I saw him, I started shivering, you know, this word shivering is telling you that tweet belongs to fear. Now, if you train your model on I'm shivering, he will kill me, I'm afraid that I will die if I do this. If you are training your model on these type of sentences, it cannot generate tweets related to joy. So it is important that when you are training your model, you show it vocabulary that you want that model to generate. It will generate those words. Yes, the composition of sentences will be different. So that is the reason why I'm saying that it will be a generating text which will be creative, which you may not have seen in past. Got the idea?
Right, sir. Yes, sir, I got the idea.
Okay. I mean, this is exactly what GPT is also doing. The only difference is in GPT, we are using transformer. You are not using LSTM, we are using transformer. Mm-hmm. Point one. Mm-hmm. Point two, GPT has been trained on whole, you know, text of internet. You know, petabyte of data. Point one. Point two, even in GPT, if you read that article, the one that I showed you in very first class, here we gave it seed text. Huh? They said we gave it a seed text. If you see the Guardian, robo article.
Sir, the last link.
Yeah.
Robot.
So they say we asked GPT, a powerful new language generator, to write an essay for us from scratch. The assignment to convince us Robo can come in peace for GPT-3 and how this essay was written and edited. Please read our edited note. we are okay. I mean somewhere it, they have mentioned the seed text that they have given to it. I think in editor's note if you go, but
sir, it's in first sentence from all 53 we were written.
I'm not a human, I'm a robot, a thinking robot. I think they gave it one paragraph and then it actually extended that whole paragraph to write this complete.
To the seed text, what to convince us robot or for peace. It's written in the first paragraph. To convince us robots come in peace.
Right. So the thing is, you need to give it a seed text, and from that seed text, it will be, you know, generating rest of the things. So here, GPT-2 has generated all these. I think here they write. Somewhere they have written, this article was written by GPT-3. GPT is a general plea. Please write a short open AD around 500 words. Keep the language simple and concise. For this essay, GPT-3 was given three instructions. Please write a short, open it around 500 words. Keep language simple and concise. Focus on why humans have nothing to fear from AI. It was also fed the following introduction. I am not a human. I am artificial intelligence. Many people think I am a threat to humanity. Stephen Hawking has warned AI could spell end of the human race. I'm here to convince you not to worry. AI will not destroy, believe me. So up to this point, they have given us the seed text. You can see they have written it here. Focus on why we have it. It was also fed following introduction. So this introduction was fed. And then it has generated everything else. Then it has generated everything else. Get the idea? So same here.
Yes, sir.
Same in our case, we actually fade 60 character.
We 60 character
from our own text. So initially, the 60 character that we got, they were these. Ace allowed himself to be persuaded to self-denial in their relief and so on. Right. So this was the first. And then you can see temperature 1.2. And temperature, then next time the text which was generated, it is this G. On the other hand, so unreasonable that how he wou, right? So you can see temperature 0.2, very predictable. After wou, there should be D, so there is G, right? So you can see on temperature 0.2, it is very much predictable, but up temperature 0.5. wou, it generates E, because you know high probable should be D after U, but we have played with the probabilities. We have actually changed the probabilities by temperature. So you can see here it generates E, which was not very much probable. Okay, so I think enough discussion about text generation. I'm expecting you people will be doing the assignment. Now I shift my focus to
end the meeting.
Seth, yes?
Sir.
Sir,
I think we should end the class and we will continue in next class.
Yes, sir.
Why?
Sir, it's been 2.5 hours continue.
Yes, sir.
So I have also continued 2.5 hours. You can see my task is tougher, to continuously talk in front of machine, and you know, no one is in doubt. It seems like,
yes sir, it's really hard.
We accept that.
It's really hard.
The problem is, if I do not teach it today, I will forget. So next week again I will have the same thing. Anyway, we can stop here. Next week we will, because these contents are so exciting, I just want to not to miss these.
Yes, sir, and we want that excitement in next class as well.
Okay. Honestly speaking, आप तो थकी पे Thank you very much. I look forward to your assignment submission. I've already given you assignment submission. Do not miss the deadline. And again, you know, you need at least 15-20 hours. It's not an assignment of 2-3 hours. Basharul, you have
So yes, sir. I have one question, sir. When it comes to word level prediction, that there might be an issue of spaces, right? Do we need to replace spaces with a word or a symbol? Because we are only taking the words.
I mean, every time you generate a word, you give a space. That is a kind of post-processing. You just generate
under words, cleaning and pre-processing.
You generate words and it is absolutely a constant at each step. That you generate word, insert a space, generate word, insert a space. So model will not give you space. Model will give you next word. Because when you were generating character, model was generating a space. But now model will not generate space because you have trained it on words, not on characters. So when you have generated words, you know, if you want 400 word, give sequence, model will generate first word, then second word, then third word. When you have generated all 400 words, how to make sentences, you know, first word, insert a space, second word, insert a space, and so on. So there, you really, it's just a post-processing step.
Yeah, my question is, say suppose if we are having a scenario like there's a question and at the end of the question we have a question mark. So when we are taking a word, we have to take the word with the question mark, right?
Mm-hmm.
Because there'll be punctuation marks, there'll be spaces. So that's what I'm asking.
You know, this issue of question mark, I don't think model... Actually, in that case, you might have trained a model. Question mark comes after certain words. So that question mark will be considered as a part of the sentence. Part of the word. You're right. I mean, to be very honest with you, these models are very bad at generating questions. These models are not good at generating questions. Because question mark can appear with any word. Are you out of your mind? There is question mark. It means with mind there can be question mark. But my mind is spoiling. My mind is, you know, freezing. Again, here, mind is not coming with the question mark. Question mark with a word and finite possibilities. I mean, all the words in dictionary, they can come with the question mark. Are you sure? Again, question mark. So with the noun, with the adjective, is this beautiful? You can say again, question mark. So, you know, generating question mark with word, I don't think the LSTM models can do well. You need sentence level generation. When you do sentence level generation, you know that when this is the structure of sentence, there should be question. Irfan?
Yes, sir. Actually, this falls in sarcasm and we deal this by pre-processing. I mean, we can remove these question mark from text and then we can train a model.
Right.
Because
my question is, if there is a question mark in a question, that is a question, right? So then we have to add that question mark. So in that scenario, what we have to do? So in pre-processing, we are actually removing all these symbols and all. But I think you didn't get my question very well.
No, I got your question, but see, is this beautiful? Means how you will define this to it? Whether it's a positive, negative, or it's a joy or surprise? I mean, you cannot define this question.
It's not about sentiments. It's about, text creation.
Yeah, but the model will learn that if you provide this text on enjoy category and also similar you can have in sadness or happy category, similar sentences. You know? So how will you generate these tweets like this?
No, it's not about sentiments. I'm talking about text generation. When we are generating a question, then there will be a question mark at the end of the word. So again, if we are going to generate something like a question, then there might be an issue. So that's what I'm asking.
Probably I'm
Okay, guys, I think that's all for the day. Thank you for your time. I'm going to stop here. This recording of today's session, I will keep on, my YouTube channel and add that link on LMS. So if you want to see it again, you should be able to.
Yes, sir.
Thank you. Thank you all for joining.
Thank you, sir.
See you again.
Thank you, sir.
Sir, I am.
Someone.
Sir?
Yes, sir.
Sir, I was saying, can you please share the assignment with me because I cannot log in into my LMS and I have not joined your class on LMS.
Saif, can you do that?
I will share.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Okay, thank you.
I was waiting for your end, sir. I will share.
Thank you. Thank you, sir. Bye-bye. Allah Hafiz.
Allah Hafiz, sir.
Allah Hafiz. See you.